Planting cover crops enhances the soil's ability to function as a nutrient recycler. Penn State's Dr. Sjoerd Dulker talks about how dairy farmers in his state are using cover crops to improve their businesses without regulations or subsidies.
In my work, I have concentrated on helping farmers adopt no-tillage systems, diversify their crop rotations, and also to fill any fallow periods in the crop rotation with living vegetation, so that our principles, our guiding philosophy is basically to have a living vegetation and living root systems in the soil 365 days a year. So I have a project that is actually called Without Carrot or Stick, because we are trying to stimulate the farmers to adopt cover crops without a carrot of subsidies, without a stick of regulation. Usually we have 10 dairy farmers all over Pennsylvania, and it is all focused on cover crops after corn silage. There is a good window for planting the cover crops, and there is a good also opportunity for using the cover crops for forage. Instead of them buying feed from outside, they are cycling more nutrients on their own farm. It's going through the animal, they're producing some products, they're producing manure, the manure goes back on the field. If we can produce more feed on our own farm and cycle more nutrients on our own farms, it is very beneficial.
How does that make you feel?
Yeah, that is very satisfying. We've already seen an enormous increase in the adoption of no-tillage, but now we want to really emphasize, as part of that no-till system, we need to fill all those fallow periods with living crops. And so the cover crops are a big part of that. And we see that now our farmers are actually starting to use those practices. So we think it will be very beneficial for soil quality, for nutrient management, nutrient cycling. And the farmers are intensifying their production. So we hope they can produce more forage on their own farm, to cycle more nutrients on their own farm.